Good morning, everyone. We are from Group 6 and want to present about Characters on Triples by Susan Glasspell. Next. My name is Olivia Salsa and my student number 112.
My name is Nasya Ramani Ramadhani. My student number is 108.
My name is Olivia Novi Fauzetti with student number 118.
My name is Ananda Fabia Natasha with student number 120.
And my name is Gita Shananda Murti with student number 130.
We are going to present about the relationship between characters, describe the alliances and conflicts the characters have with other characters, and describe the attitudes the characters have toward other characters and their attitudes toward them. Next. There are 7 characters. The first is Mrs. Hale, is one of the red snake birds. She is married to the farmer Lewis Hale. The second is Mrs. Peters, is married to the sheriff Henry Peters. The third is George Henderson, is a confident young country attorney. The fourth is Lewis Hale, is a farmer and neighbor of the Wrights. The fifth is Henry Peters, is a local sheriff. The sixth is Mr. Wright, has been found murdered. The investigative plot centers around this death. And the last is Mrs. Sprite, is suspected of murdering her husband. Next. Mrs. Hale, she represents the voice of every woman without any recognized authority. Although she seems reluctant to speak up, she takes a firm position against male criticism when she does. She is the first to recognize the mood of farmhouse and draw a conclusion regarding Mrs. Worthy's isolation. She acts as a caregiver, looking out for both Mrs. Peters and Mrs. Wright. Finally, she thinks well under pressure when she hides the dead canary. Next.
In the beginning, Mrs. Peters clearly aligns with the men, defending them and their action. When Mrs. Hale criticizes them for their instruction to Mrs. White's face. At the same time, she is the one who moves the woman from just waiting and helping the men to a more active evaluation of the situation, asking Mrs. Hale if she thinks Mrs. White killed her husband and sharing information about the case that her husband had default to her.
George Henderson, he is the county attorney. George Henderson is the county attorney. Is a young man who seems full of himself and the power of his office. He takes control of the situation as soon as he enters the Wright's house. He directs others, interrupts them when they are speaking, and in general assumes he will be in control of all exchanges. There is something of the politician about him when he realizes the woman has been offended early in the play. He makes a condescending show of reaching out to them and acknowledging their value. The audience learns little or nothing about his personal life. All they see is the man as office holder.
Next is Lewis Hale. Hale seems a basic, solid fellow. He's neighborly and relatively straightforward, but not stupid. He discovered Mr. White's murder the day before the play is set when he stopped by the house to see if Mr. White wanted to share the cost of a phone line with him. He was hoping Mrs. Wright had persuaded Mr. Wright to go in on the phone line with him. This suggests he knows that wives sometimes persuade their husbands, and women may have a greater interest in communication than men. He is, however, openly baffled by Mrs. Wright's behavior when he visits. He does not understand how she can be calm when her husband is dead.
And the last character is Henry Peters. So although he exists primarily to fill the role of sheriff and carry out his part in the investigation, Henry Peters does have some independent identity that sets him apart. When the country attorney challenges his process, suggesting that Peters should have left someone there overnight to preserve the crime scene, Peters justifies and defends his actions, providing larger context for the investigation. He comes across as caring, overworked, and fundamentally more human than the country attorney. When the subject of Mrs. Wright's disordered kitchen comes up, he displays sexism and condescension even to his own wife, from whom he expects loyalty. Next. That's all from our group's presentation, and thank you for watching.